A familiar sight of a tribal chief poised for battle. Stalking Orton and ready to pounce. Reigns. Oh, RKO! RKO!
Sales.
R-Truth hustling those shirts. JD McDonough said, don't mind if I do.
All right. It's all you, dog.
Well, JD will take the money, won't he?
And this from behind. Scott Hudson finale. What? Oh, no. Jimmy Uso. Jimmy Uso of the Bloodline! What the hell is he doing here?
What the hell is Jimmy Uso doing here?
What is that? High Solo with a Samoan spike! The damn Bloodline is here!
The hell is the Bloodline doing here?
Roman Reigns warned Cody Rhodes. McIntyre saw what transpired. He hits a claymore to take advantage.
No.
McIntyre cover for the win.
No.
Numbers games.
Damon Kemp. Don't realize it coming in, and Gulak got taken out. But Gulak saved Charlie Dempsey at the last moment. A big suplex. Shoulders down. He got him. He got him.
Just taken him to new heights along with the No Quarter Catch crew.
An homage to Big E of the New Day, but Vinci sending Kofi crashing through a table. Bang off the face of Xavier Woods. Kaiser sends Woods headfirst into a chair. Roll up, grabs the jeans and the win.
Tonight is a different story. There's something off about Joe Gacy, and Dijak doesn't like it.
I don't think Gacy's gonna stay down. And Dijak has never faced someone like Gacy, and now just stomping away through the trash can.
I told you to stay down, and now you're gonna pay the price.
Well, Dijak has a plan, but...
And Montez about to do what he does best, a little message for Karrion Kross.
Notice Scarlett had the official distracted, which allowed Karrion Kross to strike. Oh, damn! The Almighty unleashing his wrath.
Cross got involved in the matchup behind the referee's back, and he's paying the price now.
The Almighty bringing the fight to Karrion Kross of the Final Testament. Kross just launched the elbow of Bobby Lashley into the ring post. And now with a steel chair. Oh, my God.
Lashley's going to compete in the Elimination Chamber tomorrow.
Lashley might have a broken arm.
There's a lot of things getting broken out here tonight, thanks to this Final Testament.
That's exactly what the Final Testament has set out to do. Change the game, tell the story on their terms. What a win.
You're gonna need more than that, Giovanni.
Double team, one day!
There we go!
A massive 1D from the New Day and Jey Uso. Kofi Kingston gonna fly. So is main event Jey Uso with the splash, the cover.
The end of days! Is that the end of the round? Oh, there's the dive! Taking out Corbin, but Braun in perfect position. Stacks his rock. Breaker looking for the spear!
One, two, three,
they've done it!
Here are your winners! And new NXT Tag Team Champions!
The celebration begins for the Wolf Dogs.
Can you believe it? Baron Corbin, Braun Breaker, your new NXT Tag Team Champions.
Samoa dropped to Naomi. Now turning her attention to Morgan and Stratton.
It's Tiffy time.
A lot of these women forgetting Nia Jax. All we're talking about Rhea Ripley, but Nia Jax! Maybe the women's champion comes Saturday.
Nia Jax, unstoppable.
Turning her attention to Bianca Belair and running right through her. LA Knight, cover for the win.
What the hell? AJ Styles!
What the hell did AJ Styles come from?
Styles is mangling LA Knight with a steel chair.
Corey, where the hell did Styles come from?
I have no idea. There's so many bodies in the ring. There are superstars. There's officials. There's AJ Styles.
Did he come in through the open door that they opened up to get Lashley out?
It may have been the case. We saw Logan Paul do something similar last year at the expense of Rollins. But
AJ Styles, who's had this long simmering rivalry with LA Knight. LA Knight cost Styles an opportunity to be in this chamber match tonight, and Styles has not forgotten that.
Styles feels as though LA Knight cost him a chance to knock off Roman Reigns.
Styles clash on the chair.
Please withdraw this challenge from The Rock. Or else.
I am absolutely fed up with being nice. If it's a bloodline setup, like I said, come and get me.
May I?
No. If one more person takes a step towards me, I am dropping every single person standing in this ring.
That threat doesn't apply if I'm that one person to come close to you, right?
Wrong.
A defiant Cody Rhodes. Steel chair in hand. Unloading on Heyman's henchman.
Roman Reigns. Call The Rock.
Go ahead, Mr. Heyman. Call him. Because the bloodline isn't hunting me. I'm hunting the bloodline!
You destroyed the thing, the SmackDown thing. Whoa.
Oh. Focus on your match. Don't talk to me.
Oh!
That's what I'm talking about.
Very difficult to focus on anything with the Maverick Logan Paul KO ringside, and this one's going into meltdown before our eyes. It was only a matter of time.
Yeah, we should have seen this, Wade. You and I have been doing this long enough to know better.
Oh, there you go.
Owens is going to force the disqualification.
Oh,
dear.
Logan Paul flattened in the process by KO. Brawls everywhere you look. Four of our superstars who will be competing in the Elimination Chamber tomorrow morning.
BFT by night. Here comes the Almighty.
Got injured earlier tonight.
Bear.
Throwing the wounds of war on that right elbow.
Logan Paul from behind, kicking at the injured elbow of Lashley. Stunner. Spear. This is madness! These five men will all step inside of the Elimination Chamber. We are going walking on a dream. Oh my God!
Here's the problem in a match like the Elimination Chamber. You simply do not have enough eyes to stay safe.
Perth, woo! Australia, buckle up! Tomorrow morning, 5 a.m. Eastern, wait a minute! RKO from out of nowhere!
Wait, what the hell's happening?
They don't call him the big strong boy for nothing. Many people's pound for pound strongest in WWE, Tyler Bate.
Round and round we go.
DIY all out of sorts.
Man, I gave myself a hernia just watching that from Tyler Bay. That was impressive stuff.
Tag made. Pete Dunne now legal. No, 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 no.
Stratton launches herself off the pod.
A swanton takes out the field.
He's got Orton right where he wants him. RKO out of nowhere!
Or does he?
Oh, Logan Paul with the brass knuckles! That damn Logan Paul just hit Orton with the damn knuckles!
Now before The Rock drops some gospel on you, The Rock has got some good news to share. Something that's gonna make you happy, something that you can own. Tonight, it is official. You all, right now, live on Fox, have broken an all-time indoor attendance record. Not only... not only for the city of Salt Lake, but for the entire state of Utah, congratulations. Well, here's the record you broke. You broke the all-time record for the largest gathering of trailer park trash The Rock has ever seen. Now, if you didn't like that, you're gonna love this. Finally. Oh, you want to boo that, huh? Are you sure you want to boo The Rock? Finally. Your life has meaning. Cody, your story is just ending. Our story is just beginning. The Bloodline, the most powerful dominant duo in sports and entertainment, and of course in the WWE. If you No. Salt Lake City, sing along with The Rock is over. You lost that privilege. Sit there and shut your mouth and enjoy the ride that The Rock is taking you on. If you what the Bloodline is cooking.
Stalking the Maverick, here comes the Almighty.
Through the pod!
Logan's dead.
I've given you Nia Jax for the championship at the Elimination Chamber. That works for you? Then please, let's keep the show going. This is not the time. Let us.
Not so fast, General Manager Pierce, because marching to the ring, the irresistible force Nia Jax, who last week on this program annihilated Rhea Ripley. And here we go, and the fight's on. Why wait to Elimination Chamber? Oh, and Nia Jax just blasting into Pierce's. Pierce is calling for security, and Ripley and Nia Jax beating the hell out of each other.
Rhea Ripley's throwing bombs on Nia Jax.
And now a security trying to separate these women. Nia Jax screaming at the champion. Deep disdain between these two. Jax blowing through everybody to flatten Ripley. And now she's assaulting security officers. And you thought McIntyre was in hot water. Wait until we see how Nia Jax is addressed by our general manager. But before that,
second rope.
And an annihilator to Rhea Ripley.
I see it perfectly.
Stardom to Spine.
Here is your winner, the man, Becky Lynch.
What great ring awareness by Becky Lynch.
That ring awareness made all the difference. But the ring awareness is why Becky Lynch has headlined WrestleMania, why she is headed there yet again with another golden opportunity.
Here is your winner, Drew McIntyre!
Hey, listen, Drew McIntyre calls himself the workhorse. I call him a hypocrite. McIntyre did what he had to do to win tonight. I understand that. But Logan Paul just cost Randy Orton an opportunity to battle for the world title at WrestleMania, and that's a damn shame.
I agree with you wholeheartedly on everything that you just said. McIntyre called his shot and delivered the goods tonight in the chamber.
When you, me, and Dakota started this, we were like this ever since they came around. You turned your back on me. What happened?
Oh my God! The Kabuki Warriors from behind, laying waste to the woman who was at one time the leader of Damage Control.
There has been a malignant stench inside Damage Control for some time, and it's coming to a head before our eyes. Founder of Damage Control battered.
Wait, look at Bayley just grab from under the ring.
Yeah, Bayley's no dummy, I assure you of that.
Oh my God! Bayley's got a pipe! Bayley must have known this was gonna happen!
The ultimate equalizer.
Announcement. Io, I'll see you at WrestleMania.
You are on one hell of a run, one of the most impressive I have ever seen. And even though for the last year you have been the face of this company, you've spent most of the time being fed grapes by this loser. Meanwhile, I have been the backbone, the heart and soul of this company. Became a Grand Slam champion, all while writing a best-selling book. Because the man can do it all, including beating Rhea Bloody Ripley.
I just want to say congratulations at winning the Elimination Chamber match. It's about time that you stop disappointing me and actually won something to get close to my level. The man always thinks that they're the backbone of everything. But the funny thing is that behind every great man is a greater woman. But I'm not behind you, Becky. Because mommy is always on top.
Roman Reigns, he gets more power. He gets more leverage, which means he shows up less. He defends his title less. That glass ceiling, it gets thicker. Those brass rings, they get higher. This is probably the last real chance that any of us has to take that title, to take that power, and to give it to the people.
Now, you and I, we haven't always seen eye to eye, but a couple weeks back, you told Roman Reigns you didn't just want to take his title from him, you wanted to take everything from him, and deep in my soul, I felt that.
And that is why at the press conference, when The Rock laid hands on you, I stepped up, because I am sick and I am tired of people like The Rock, of people like Roman Reigns, these arrogant, entitled pricks who think they can do whatever they want. They can throw their weight around, make any decision they want with no consequence. I am sick and tired of them always getting away with it.
When it comes to fighting The Rock, when it comes to fighting Roman Reigns, there is only one man on earth who is uniquely suited to be your shield. I'll give you a hint. He was once an architect. He is now a visionary. He is a revolutionary. He is Seth
freaking Rollins! You're embarrassing your entire family now. You, just understand this, you're irrelevant, just like your dad.
Here you are. Here you are talking about family. Is that what the bloodline is? Let me ask you a question. How's Jay? It's not a family. You're a meal ticket, and they are nothing but lackeys, but yes men. They're goons. And what is this match all about right here? Who sits at the head of the table? What does it matter when neither of you have been doing any of the cooking for 2 years? Earlier, we had that family tree up there, and you've invoked my father before, so let me go ahead and do the same. If your grandfather was here, if the High Chief, his grandfather, was here, they'd be ashamed of you.
Let me make something perfectly clear to you. When you talk about his family, you're talking about my family. When you're talking about his ancestors, you're talking about my ancestors. And when you're talking about his blood, you're talking about my blood. So now, we have a problem.